My friend Matt Miller and I met at a meeting at an anime club that a friend of mine dragged me to. It was at the Hooksett Public Library, and we both noticed each other because he was wearing a top hat and I was completely bald at that point. So when mutual friends of ours introduced each other, we knew we were going to be great friends. Matt Miller is my all-time best friend because we've been there for each other through huge transition points in our lives. Matt Miller and I hang out every single weekend and play video games until ungodly hours of the morning. Everyone has that friend who is always there for them, and for me, that's Matt. First, I'll tell a little bit about Matt's history. Second, the milestones in our friendship, and lastly, Matt and mine's personal friendship. No one knows Matt like I know Matt. First, Matt, before we even met, he had plenty of parental issues. His mom got angry with him one time, and he was sent to live with his dad in Florida. However, he had to deal with plenty of siblings he really had no connection to, about 10 half-siblings, and his father was a horrible drunk. Then, when he got home, his mother had a horrible boyfriend who took a $100 bill from his wallet and put it in Matt's room and blamed Matt for it, and had threatened to injure Matt by breaking his hand. But luckily, Matt's mom, on the way to pick Matt up from the airport one time after visiting his father, the boyfriend had said that he was going to hurt her. So she broke up with him immediately and never saw him again, which definitely helped his and his mother's relationship. A couple years back, Matt came out to me before coming out to anyone else that he was pansexual, and I was also identifying as pansexual at that time, so it was easier for both of us. He couldn't really tell his mother because she wasn't very accepting of him, but accepting of others. And recently, after showing me a Tumblr post, he told me that he would prefer to be a woman. And I was upset for a few days because she couldn't tell me in person and only showed me their Tumblr post and then told me in person. But it only brought us closer because we realized that we shouldn't be upset about anything. And it was just a confidence issue. But our friendship has been a huge bright point in both of our lives. As I said before, we hang out every single weekend, and a couple times Matt's slept over, and we used our smart TV to just watch really random YouTube videos at like 3 a.m, and it was wonderful. We're still working on making an overnight bag because they stay over so often, still don't have anything in their car, but we'll also watch horror flicks, and the ones you find on Hulu that aren't on the web are usually very strange, dubbed, foreign horror films, and they're absolutely hilarious, and we try to make up dialogue over them, because the translations are just awful, they're hilarious. Most of the time when Matt comes over, we play tons of video games, and usually horror games. We weren't able to upload it, but we played the entire first Silent Hill game on a PlayStation emulator, and it was crappy graphics and a lot of uncomfortable like feelings between both of us, not sure if we could continue playing, and it took us several weeks to finish. But it was a lot of fun, and we continued to put out more material on our YouTube and go over our strange YouTube shenanigans. But I would like to make a toast to our friendship. As Matt transitions to womanhood and I transition to adulthood, I hope our friendship only strengthens. And thank you for sharing this special tribute with me, and thank you to Matt for being my friend.